Hi, this presentation is going to go over different statistical measures of fertility. But before we look at the measures, we should first be careful about our definitions. We need to separate births, which is an event leading to a newborn, from natality, which is probably a term most people have not heard of. That's the effect of birth on population as a whole. Reproduction, which has to do with the ability to sustain a population. Fertility, which is the rate of births, and then another term that perhaps you're not familiar with, fecundity, which is the physical capacity of women to give birth, sort of the opposite of sterility, and that number usually is around 15. It's the physical maximum for women. The most common of the measures, the common period measures many of the viewers here might be familiar with, are the crude birth rate, which we've discussed in other presentations already. That's sort of the overall number of births to the overall population. Then we have age-specific fertility rates, which breaks the population down into an age structure for women, and then examines the fertility rate for each of the different age cohorts, age groups. And then the total fertility rates, which is the weighted sum of all the age-specific fertility rates. Two other period measures that are maybe less familiar to the viewer are the general fertility rate, which limits the age range from the total fertility rate to only those women in childbearing years. So the number of births relative to the population of women between the ages of 15 and 44. The gross reproductive rate is another one that's perhaps less familiar. It's the same as the total fertility rate, but only focuses on those births that result in females, not males. So that's going to be about half of the total fertility rate. So it's about half of births result in females instead of males. Next, the net reproduction rate goes another step beyond the GRR, the gross reproductive rate. And only focuses on those female births that survive past the age of one, because infant mortality does claim a large number of births. So the net reproductive rate is going to be a little more accurate in terms of predicting the future reproduction rate, for instance. Another useful measure is the child-woman ratio, which has to do with the population of children age 0 to 5 relative to the population of women in childbearing years. With a wider definition of that from 15 to 49. We should note that all these period measures that we've looked at could be converted to cohort measures. Again, the difference is instead of looking at separate groups, we're looking at the same group through time, right? So that's the difference between a cohort and a period measure. Here's a simple comparison of the United States and India to show how some of these different measures look. Just on the face of things. So first we have the child-woman ratio, the CWR, and there we can see in the United States that's 278.7, whereas in India it's 374.18. So clearly there are more children relative to women in India as compared to the United States. The total fertility rate, India also comes out ahead there, 1.9 versus 2.55. The gross reproductive rate for the United States, 0.98, which is right about at replacement level, whereas India is over that at 1.2. And then the crude birth rate, India comes in almost twice that of the United States, 22 versus 13. Here's another international comparison that now breaks things down into different age groups, so we can compare the age-specific fertility rate along with the total fertility rate and the gross reproduction rate at the bottom there. So if we go across here, we can see the total fertility rate differences for India, Lithuania, Italy, Rwanda, the United States, and Latvia, and below that, the gross reproductive rate. And you see similar patterns. Recall that the gross reproductive rate is usually about half of the total fertility rate, because that's the total fertility rate for girls only. So it's about half of the births. And if we look at the age-specific fertility rates, we see quite a big difference here across countries. Rather large numbers for Rwanda, for example. Its total fertility rate is 4.9, the highest on the table here. The modal category in Rwanda is 25 to 29, whereas if you look at Italy, it's 30 to 34, 35 to 39 as a high number, but it's 30 to 34. And in Lithuania, it's 25 to 29. In the United States, it's actually younger, it's 20 to 24. Sorry, that's India. In the United States, it's 25 to 29. So we got, you can kind of see actually a relationship between where the modal age-specific fertility rate is highest compared to the total fertility rate. And generally speaking, where you have more young women giving birth, the higher the fertility rate will be. And that's both a matter of absolute numbers, but also relative numbers. And finally, here's a global map of the total fertility rate of the world in 2015, which at the time being is the most recent available data. And what we see is the highest fertility rates in the lighter colors, which includes much of Central Africa, some parts of Asia, which actually are missing data here, it appears. And then we've got the low fertility rates in the dark blue. And you can see there we've got Canada, we've got, well, Japan should be there, it's not showing up with data, Brazil, and much of Europe. And that's going to conclude our discussion of measures of fertility. Thanks for watching.